The other major story tonight, the global aftershocks after that vote in Britain, and for so many around the world, a stunning result. Deciding to leave the European Union, to go it alone. Wall Street here at home plummeting more than 600 points, and the faces in Britain, those who thought there was no way this could happen. Then another surprise, the Prime Minister of Britain announcing his resignation, walking back into 10 Downing Street, his arm around his wife. And here in America, fear over Americans and their savings, the Dow ending the day down more than 600 points. And tonight, as the reality sets in, evidence some British voters may be having second thoughts. One of the top Google searches in the UK, what is the European Union? Voters asking what it is, they just left. ABC's chief foreign correspondent Terry Moran with the moment overnight the UK learned this was really happening.
The epic decision coming after a long night of suspense that began the moment the polls closed.
Counting is underway of tens of millions of votes in the EU referendum.
More than 30 million votes cast, each ballot counted by hand. Within minutes, the first results and a sign of things to come. The northern working-class city of Newcastle barely voting to remain in the European Union. And nearby Sunderland, a landslide vote to leave. The market's already sensing danger as those first returns start coming in. The hours pass, people staying up all night, their faces etched with anxiety, a whole country on edge.
A night of great suspense, but we don't know what's going to happen, do we?
And every hour made the pattern clearer. You can see it on the map. England and Wales voting to get out of the EU, London and the suburbs voting to stay, and Scotland and Northern Ireland overwhelmingly pro-EU. Just before dawn, the BBC calls it.
The British people have spoken, and the answer is we're out.
For those who wanted to stay in the European Union, utter heartbreak. Like J.K. Rowling, creator of Harry Potter, who tweeted, "I don't think I've ever wanted magic more." And Scotland will seek independence now. But it was sweet, sweet victory for those like Nigel Farage, whose right-wing party fought for this moment for years.
The sun has risen on an independent United Kingdom.
As the morning papers blared the news, some were stunned.
I'm completely and utterly devastated. Can't actually believe it's happened.
Others delighted.
Winston Churchill would be proud of us. He'd be up there now looking down at us. Well done, Great Britain.
And the agony of defeat. Prime Minister David Cameron outside number 10 Downing Street choking back emotion with the surprise announcement he would resign in the coming months.
I love this country and I feel honored to have served it.
It was an emotional campaign, and immigration was a driving issue. This controversial poster capturing the feeling of so many. Breaking point. Late morning, Prime Minister Cameron going to Buckingham Palace, meeting with Queen Elizabeth to chart a way forward. And the hangover, and in some cases, regret.
Simply because this morning the reality is actually hitting in, and the regrets are filling in.
And Terry Moran with us live from London tonight. Terry, so what next? Because this isn't simply a 24-hour aftershock. This is going to take weeks, months, perhaps years.
Exactly, David. What happens next is that Britain and Europe must now negotiate a complicated and painful divorce. There's hundreds of billions of dollars, thousands of laws that needed to get sorted out. Britain wants to go slow on that. But today, European leaders say they want Britain out for good as soon as possible. David?
Terry Moran with us all day on this. Terry, thank you.